Welcome back, everybody. It's time to head back into Hawaii's kitchen with the folks from Maize Hawaii.
Yeah, first it was the Terry Burger. Now they're cooking up the Kimchi Beach Burger. Ooh, take a look.
We are back here at Ferguson Showroom with the gang from Maize Hawaii. We've got Executive Chef Ryan Day to my left, and we welcome in Kevin Oguma. Hello.
Hi.
Hello. So what are you making for us for this segment?
We're making a picnic beef Kimchi Beach Burger.
That's a whopper of a name.
That's a
tongue twister. Tongue twister.
Delicious.
All right, so what do we have here? We made Terry Burgers in our last one, but we're using it's the picnic burger.
We're using the picnic burger.
Okay, how does that differ from the Terry Burger?
Well, we don't have that teriyaki ingredients. So
okay.
It's one of these burgers that you can see fried at McDonald's or something like that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what do we do? What are
we got finished cooking our picnic burger.
Okay.
We're gonna go ahead and throw one right on top of our bun.
Now while you're doing that, Yummo. I hear that you have a story about these burgers.
Yes, I do, this burger was introduced to me by my grandfather.
Okay.
We used to go picnicking or camping down at Swansea Beach Park.
While you're telling the story, what do we do here?
Swansea Beach Park, and we'll go down to Kahana or even Bellows. Well, and then when it was lunchtime, Grandpa used to call everyone down, and we always had sand in our hair, sand in our mouth. sand all over.
Of course, I remember those days.
Whenever we did eat our burger, we had sand all over. So Grandpa, what he did, took a little kimchi. First he took the cheese. He took the kimchi. This kimchi is to go ahead and help so that the sand tastes a little better when it goes down. Tastes a little better so that when it goes down, and there we go.
Oh, that looks good.
Look at that bad boy.
Good.
And it's crunchy too, right?
I love that. I've actually had burgers with kimchi in it, and it's so flavorful.
Yes, it is.
I love it.
What also my grandfather did is that there's times when we were walking down to the beach, we had a plate, we had our soda in one hand. Well, he said, combine everything. We threw potato chips in our sandwich. So it's a one-hand meal.
I have also heard of people putting chips, and it's a nice crunchy flavor.
Yeah.
Crunchy. Right.
Gives it a good texture.
Now, Chef, of course, you know, every week we're cooking with gas. But tell us, what are some of the benefits for you?
I love cooking with gas. The main benefit is you get direct heat, and you're able to control the heat. So the other types of cooking, you have to let it cool down. You have to pull the pan off, let the pan cool down, where heat is direct. The gas is direct heat.
Okay.
So it's easy to, you don't burn everything. You can control or turn it down. Like
I did
a melting
hear
butter
that all true chefs cook with gas.
Yeah.
I
unless you're
too.
Like camping, but even then you bring the propane stove or something. It's
yeah.
easy. Yeah.
All right. Well, great.
Love that gas.
We're going to cut this up and maybe throw some chips in
there
just for old time's
idea.
Sake.
Great idea.
Keep your eye on him. He's going to eat it all. Watch.
Oh, no. Are you kidding?
Okay. Oh, she's got first pick.
I've got the elbow. All right. And in our last segment, what are we making, guys?
We're going to do the blue cheese power burger with our premium patties.
Is that what the bacon is for?
That's my secret weapon.
You know, everything tastes better with bacon.
Yes. Yeah. That's true.
Yeah. All right. Thank you so much. We're going to be right back. Maize has so many choices.
Yes.
And it's so fast and easy
so
to make.
So many ideas, too.
Yes.
And again, if you ever know, and a lot of people know on the backside, a lot of their boxes, recipes right there.
Yes.
They have all the recipes
yes.
right there. So
and
it's
I
easy.
Thank you for that.